You know, it's so hard to believe that it's almost Christmas time again. But boy, I sure do love Christmas. Especially Granny's turnip greens and hog jaws and cornbread and, oh, I can't forget my favorite, Granny's fruit cake. Ooh, I'm getting hungry just thinking about it. Here she comes.
Yoletide, where are you?
I'm right here, Granny.
Yoletide, you're not going to believe this. It's
what
awful.
Is it? Well, Granny, it can't be no worse than that iPad thing they sent us last Christmas.
Oh, it's worse. It's horrible. It's much worse than that iPad contraption.
Well, Granny, we can put it up in the attic with all the other city stuff they send us. But what is it?
A cookbook. They sent me a cookbook.
Well, Granny, don't you like to cook?
Well, of course I like to cook. Have you ever seen me use one of these things?
Now, you're right about that. It's always a pinch here and a dash there, and We're your guinea pigs. We just try it all. But anyhow, but you know what, Granny? It reminds me that it might be kind of lonely without having Cora May and Luther here this Christmas.
My poor youngins, reckon what they gonna have to eat for Christmas dinner?
Well, if we're talking about the city, they may go to some fancy restaurant and not even be able to pronounce what's on the menu.
God bless them.
I know, in Jesus' name. At least we'll be eating good. But you know, it was good having them here last Christmas. Good thing their car broke down.
You know, Yuletide, do you remember all that noise and all that caterwauling that them city youngins called music?
Do I remember it? My goodness, my hearing aid's still crying about it.
Thank God
that
for
jingle bell rap, I tell you.
Thank God for our country singing.
Amen. I tell you what, but most of all, what I remember about last Christmas, they got to hear the Christmas story for the very first time, and it changed their lives forever.
to hear the Christmas story. How the angel came down to the little old gal named Mary.
Yes,
told her she was going to have a young'un. Now, Mary was a little bit nervous and scared because she was engaged to Joseph, but they wasn't married. She wasn't supposed to be having no young'uns. But the angel told her it was all part of God's big old plan. And he told her that her young'un was going to be a boy. Told her she was going to name him Jesus. Told her he was going to be the Son of God. He was going to be a king. Ain't that just amazing?
Granny, that is amazing.
And that poor old angel, he's kind of busy because Joseph, when Mary told him what was going on, he was like, whoo, now we engaged, but we ain't married. You ain't supposed to be having no young'uns. And so Joseph was like, okay, I guess I need to put her away somewhere. I don't know what's going on here. So God had to get it straightened out real quick. So he sent that angel Gabriel back to Joseph. He told Joseph, he said, God's got a plan. This is all part of God's plan. You just do what you're supposed to do. So Joseph did what he was supposed to do. Jesus was born. And you know what? He was born a Savior. And he's still saving people today.
Well, Granny, you're right about that. Jesus changed the world. You know, I think I'm going to read the Christmas story again.
Yeah, I'll flip through my cookbook while you read the story to me.
All right. And it came to pass in those days, there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, into the city of David, which is now called Bethlehem, to be taxed with his espoused wife, being great with child. Thank you.
there, and it was so while they were there. The days were accomplished that she should be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings, which shall be unto all people joy. Can you imagine how that shepherd felt seeing an angel, and the angel had come with great news of a king being born? Man, it must have been awesome to be one of those shepherds.
And you know what, Yuletide?
What?
Them shepherds was country people just like me and you.
Hey, that's right. That's exactly right.
Oh, my goodness. You're not going to believe this.
What is it, Granny?
Three words. Oven fried chicken.
Now, that's just of the devil.
Mm. Oven fried chicken. You can't fry chicken in the oven. You got to put chicken on the stove in a big old cast iron skillet. What are these people thinking?
Can the church say amen? I tell you what, I know, Granny, who would have thought of that? Oven fried chicken. My goodness. Now, Granny, you got me all distracted. I'm trying to tell the Christmas story. Can you put that cookbook away? And
I'm
your
sorry.
Favorite part's coming up.
I know. I'm sorry. You know my mind just wanders off sometimes.
Well, I know it does.
Look, I'm going to put my cookbook up.
All right. I'm going to sit here.
I'm going to be real quiet, and I'm going to listen. I'm going to be
all real quiet. Well, let me get back to the story. Let's see here. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God, saying, Glory to God in the highest, on earth peace and goodwill to all men.
Go Tigers!
were going away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord had made known unto us." And they came with haste, and they found Mary, Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. Folks, this Christmas season, we reflect how Christ was born in a manger in the town of Bethlehem, and how he robed himself in flesh and became a man to redeem man for all eternity and to give us all the perfect gift of salvation that we can all open up one day, and most of all, to give peace to all of our hearts.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart be this on Christmas Day. We want to shout, hip, hip, hooray! It's a very special day in a very special way. We're so glad you came to Earth.
Can we give them all a great big hand? Amen. I think they've done a superb job.